New details are now emerging regarding the U.S. Army's land-based hypersonic weapon endeavor. According to Breaking Defense, a U.S. Army spokesperson said the Long Range Hypersonic Weapon (LRHW) provides a capability at a distance greater than 2,775 kilometers. So it will at least be able to hit targets 1,725 miles away. Viewers may note that LRHW's range means that it would have been prohibited under the now-defunct Intermediate Range Nuclear Forces Treaty, or INF, that the United States and Russia were parties to until 2019. LRHW is one of the several hypersonic weapons development programs being undertaken by the U.S. military. Reports suggest the U.S. Army is aiming to deploy the first experimental LRHW battery in 2023. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how long-range hypersonic weapon LRHW of the U.S. will level the playing field with Russia and China. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder, the most comprehensive military vehicle online game for PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, in which you can go to battle on more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s. The game has an amazing attention to detail and focuses on a realistic combat experience, which is why knowing your vehicles and skill really makes a difference. It's easy to get into, and all you need to play is nothing more but your mouse and keyboard or controller. Immerse yourself in cross-platform combat with more than 20 million other military vehicle enthusiasts from all over the world. Download and play War Thunder for free using the link in the description below, and also get a free bonus tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account. Countries like Russia, China, Israel, India, and the US have been developing sophisticated layered air defense. These systems are difficult for traditional missiles to penetrate. For example, Russia has deployed S-400 air defense system. It's designed to defend against aircraft, including 5th-generation stealth fighters, bombers, AWACS, cruise missiles, and even ballistic missiles. Russia is also working on S-500, which will be even more potent. The U.S. itself fields several systems that are designed to intercept ballistic as well as cruise missiles like THAAD, or Terminal High Altitude Area Defense, which is designed to shoot down short, medium, and intermediate-range ballistic missiles in their terminal phase. Conventional ballistic missiles follow a predictable parabolic path, which makes them vulnerable to interception. While cruise missiles can take a more erratic path, they're generally much slower, rendering them susceptible, and also don't have very long range. This is where hypersonic weapons come in. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5, or 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. There are currently 3 methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. The first is using a scramjet engine, which is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engine can power flight to supersonic speeds, while scramjet can enable the missile to reach hypersonic speeds. These engines have no moving parts and rely on the huge pressures created by fast airflow into the engine to ignite the fuel and generate thrust. The second is through the use of ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missile. As the name suggests, this kind of missile is ballistic in nature, but is launched from the air, unlike traditional ballistic missiles, which are launched from land or sea-based platforms. The third is using HGV, or hypersonic glide vehicle. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using a ballistic missile or an aircraft, where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier and glides back down to Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. Long-range hypersonic weapon, or LRHW, uses this approach. LRHW consists of a prototype ballistic missile, an all-up round, or AUR. The missile is encased in a canister. It has a diameter of 34.5 inches. To give viewers a perspective, a Tomahawk cruise missile has a diameter of about 20 inches. The missile has common hypersonic glide body, CHGB, placed on top of it. It's developed by Sandia National Laboratory, and the CHGB will be used by the different services of the U.S. military, Army, Navy, and Air Force. Viewers may note that CHGB is probably based on the Army Hypersonic Weapon, or AHW. A boost glide vehicle, the AHW, was tested in 2011 and achieved a speed of Mach 8 and a range of almost 4,000 miles, or 6,437 kilometers. The Transporter Erector Launchers, or TELs, are the modified M983A4 Heavy Expanded Mobility Tactical Trucks, HEMTT. M983A4 is currently being used in the Patriot anti-aircraft missile system. An M870 trailer is also shown, which will be used to move the TEL. AFTDS, or Advanced Field Artillery Tactical Data System, version 7.0, will be present for battle management duties. LRHW will have four transporter erector launchers, TELs, each with two missile canisters. Two near-peer rivals of the U.S. have made significant progress when it comes to hypersonic weapons. Russia has reached limited operational deployment for two hypersonic weapons, Kinzhal and Avangard. Kinzhal is an air-launched ballistic missile. It reportedly has a range of approximately 1,250 miles, or 2,000 kilometers, and a top speed of Mach 10. According to the Russian president, units in the country's southern military district, which borders Ukraine and the Black Sea, have deployed the missiles operationally. Avangard is a hypersonic boost glide vehicle. Last year, Deputy Prime Minister of Russia said the weapon flew at Mach 27 in a test. China has developed DF-17 missile, along with DF-ZF-HGV. DF-17, or Dongfeng-17, is a Chinese solid-fueled, road-mobile, medium-range ballistic missile that mounts the DF-ZF hypersonic glide vehicle. The DF-17 and DF-ZF were officially unveiled at the National Day Military Parade on the 1st of October, 2019. It's also thought to be pursuing a hypersonic cruise missile. For some time, the U.S. military has been hesitant when it came to developing and deploying hypersonic weapons. This led to U.S. military lagging in this technology. But things have changed in recent times, and the U.S. is now moving with full throttle. As per reports, the U.S. military is pursuing 9 programs that are dedicated to fielding hypersonic weapons. Not only this, the U.S. military is also looking ahead and studying the feasibility of developing an air defense system that can intercept hypersonic weapons. LRHW is a step in the right direction, and the descent strike envelope will enable it to hit targets from a reasonably good range. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.